Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to All Sports Network. My name is Mikey, and I'm here to ask you one question. Are the Utah Jazz good? Like, really, are they good? For months now, we have been asking ourselves what the fudge is going on in Utah, especially when they had traded Rudy Gobert and the Minnesota Timberwolves, as well as trading Donovan Mitchell to the Cleveland Cavaliers. It's like, what the fudge? All right, before we continue talking about the Jazz and if they're any good, let's look at what the trades consisted of during that offseason. In the Rudy Gobert trade, the Jazz got Malik Beasley, Patrick Beverley, who is now fanning with the Los Angeles Lakers. I said it, I don't care. Leadnro Bolmaro, Walker Kessler, Jarred Vanderbilt, a 2023, a 2025, a 2026, 2027, and a 2029 first round pick, plus a 2026 swap. That's a lot. But it's Gobert. Now in the Donovan Mitchell trade, the Jazz got Laur Markkanen, Collin Sexton, Ochai Agbaji, and draft picks and swaps. Everybody has to admit that no one, and I mean no one, expected that the damn Jazz were going to be contenders throughout the NBA season. At least nobody thought about them at the beginning of the season. We were like, what the hell did the new Utah Jazz ownership want to do with this damn team? Especially the new owner and Dwayne Wade, who was a co-owner. For years, they were contenders, and I mean serious contenders, with one missing all-star piece, whether it was on the defensive side or on the offensive side. They were really close. They were definitely close to getting to that championship round and maybe even winning it with that one extra player that they definitely needed. Yet when the new ownership group came into Utah in 2020, we weren't expecting them to make extreme changes. And yet we all felt that the damn trades were going to cause this team to be a losing and sinking team. Why? Well, we all assumed that the ownership was in the mood to save money in the long run just to justify the cost of the purchase years previously. I'm going to say it. I sure as heck thought they were going to be tanking to save money a la Donald Sterling. Can you say Clippers? Okay. The biggest surprises from the trades had to be undoubtedly Laur Markkanen. Laur Markkanen. He has played games where he has scored as high as 38 points, but his average is 22.3. But 38 points in a game, that's amazing. Also, by trading Gobert and Mitchell, the ball touches has increased or has been spread around to other Jazz players that were already there, like Jordan Clarkson, who is looking amazing this year. Miraculously, as of November 21, 2022, the Utah Jazz are 12-6. They have been in the first place of the conference for the majority of the 18 games played. They have been able to beat the Nuggets, the Timberwolves, the Pelicans, the Grizzlies, the Lakers, the Clippers, the Rockets, the Hawks, the Suns, and the Trailblazers. Just by looking at the list, they've been able to beat some damn good teams. But what's the answer to the question? Are the Utah Jazz good? The answer is yes. They're good, but they're not great. Greatness comes with a lot of playing time, chemistry, a great head coach, and one or two all-star players that can play consistently throughout the regular season and the playoffs. This young core of players remind me of the 2000 Sacramento Kings, where they had good players, but yet no real all-stars. And they hadn't achieved success or had that all-star player that the opposing team would try to close down or double team in the playoffs or in regular season games. But let me ask you, are they good? Are the Utah Jazz good? Tell me, leave me a comment.